you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for allowing us to be here today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for another day. So good.
You live.
Praise the Lord. Living in such perilous times. Some people today don't know which way is up and which way is down. But we're praying that the Lord will open our eyes and we'll see, thank you, Jesus, what He has in store for us. Lord, I'm asking you right now, Lord, to have your hands of protection over us, all the churches. The churches from Jacksonville, Florida, Lord. The churches in Baton Rouge, Jesus. The churches in New Orleans, La Place. And the churches, Lord Jesus, in California. Healing all those pastors and their families. Pastor Tillery, First Lady Tillery. Pastor Ryan, First Lady Loma. Bishop Harris and his First Lady and his family. Lord, I'm asking you to remember all of us. Remember my church, my family. Strengthen us. Have us to do better, be better. In Jesus' name I pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for my health, my strength. Thank you, Jesus. Exodus, the 10th chapter. Praise the Lord. We're going to start at Exodus, the 10th chapter. How many people today are happy that the Lord woke you up this morning on Sunday? How many people happy today that you had your arms to move with your hands? You don't hear me? Your legs to walk and your feet to move around. If you wear a size 9, that got to be good. If you wear a size 8, that got to be good. If you wear a size 10, that got to be good. All the way to a size 12 or a size 24. It doesn't matter. You have feet so you can put shoes on. You can wear all kinds of shoes. You can wear Michael Jordan's. You can wear alligators. You can wear boots of all shapes and sizes. You can style. For the women, you can wear 2-inch heels. You can wear 3-inch heels. And some can wear if you would, I don't even know if they have 5-inch heels, but if you could wear, and if you're a ballerina, I guess you have to be a gymnast almost to wear 5 feet, but you have to be happy and glad that God woke you up this morning. You could smell, you could look, you could see, because some people don't have no feet. Some people don't have no legs or arms. You don't hear me? Some people, they can't even see. And I got to thank the Lord for everything. I'm so appreciated that God allowed me to have all my limbs. I appreciate him so much that he allowed me to wake up this morning, to breathe his air that he supplied for me. And sometimes I said this air just supplied specifically for me. I said there's a place that I have to go, and when I go down to the supermarket, there's an aisle just for me. There's a place for me to walk in my steps just for me, that God allowed me to live yet another day. Exodus, the 10th chapter, starting at the first verse. And the Lord said unto Moses, go unto Pharaoh, for I have hardened his heart, and his heart is of the servants, that I might show these my signs before him. The second verse. And that thou mayest tell in the ears of thy son and of thy son's sons what things I've wrought in Egypt, and my signs which I have done among them, that ye may know how that I am the Lord. The third verse. And Moses and Aaron came in unto Pharaoh and said unto him, thus said the Lord God of the Hebrews, how long wilt thou refuse to humble thyself before me? Let my people go, that they may serve me. The fourth verse. Else, if thou refuse to let my people go, behold, tomorrow will I bring the locusts unto thy coast. The fifth verse. And they shall cover the face of the earth, and that once cannot be able to see the earth. And they shall eat the residue of which is escaped, which remaineth unto you from thou hail, and shall eat every tree which groweth for you out of the fields. Let's go back to the first verse. My subject today is, are you doing what God told you to do? My subject again today, are you doing what God told you to do? Now, in the first verse, it said, and the Lord said unto Moses, go unto Pharaoh, for I have hardened his heart and the heart of the servants, that I might show these my signs before him. Let's go to the third verse. Let's go to the third verse. And Moses and Aaron, notice Moses and Aaron came in unto Pharaoh's and said unto him, thus said the Lord God of Hebrews, how long wilt thou refuse to humble thyself before me? Let my people go, that they may serve me. How many people are here today? How many people are here on this thing called planet Earth? Remember when you were a child and your mama used to tell you to do certain things? Your mama either tell you to clean your room. She'll tell you to take the garbage out. You don't hear me? She'll tell you to cut the grass in the backyard. Or she'll tell the girls to fold the clothes, to do the laundry and wash dishes. How many times you said to your mom or your dad, I didn't want to do it. I didn't feel right. You know, it's funny that when your parents was telling you to do all that,
Your dad was out working, sweating hard, working hard, just so he could put food on the table. You don't hear me? He's working hard, trying to make sure that you could eat, trying to make sure that you could have a shelter over your head, so you have somewhere to lie your head, so you will be protected, safe. And he did this every day so he could pay the bills, pay the rent, pay the water, pay for your clothes, make sure you go to school and everything. And some people in that house, they didn't want to do it, but they had to do it. You don't expect your parents to work all that they work and then they come home after a hard day of work and clean up after you. The devil's alive. We're not doing that. We're not going to do that today. Now, I want to know, you already have this thing of listening, being obedient, because everybody in the house have to survive. Everybody in the house have to make it. My question to you today, are you doing what the Lord told you to do? If you notice, the child that always did everything the parents wanted to do, made their life easy, the parents will reward them by trying to make their life easy. Oh, they got favors. No, they reciprocate the same thing the child reciprocates to them. Some children don't listen. They're disobedient. You got to whip them more. Why I got whipping? She didn't get whipped. Well, when I told her to take the garbage out or wash the dishes or do the laundry, she did it. What in the world I'm going to whip her for when she's doing what I asked of her? Oh, God, why I'm going through all this? Why I lost my job? Why things not working right? Because you had faith, but you had faith without works. And faith without works cause you to go through a lot of things you don't have to do. Oh, Lord, I want $1 million, but you don't want work. You want somebody to give it to you. It don't work that way. The question is, are you doing what the Lord told you to do? Do you know if you take life the way it is when you start as a child and you keep going to level to level to level, you'll become successful. A lot of people can't understand why is it so difficult in college and why I can't get these grades up and why I can't do this. Because they failed to do the thing that they did when they were in high school. What did they do in high school? They studied. They did their homework every day. You don't hear me? They did their homework every day. They studied. And it was easy for them to do well on the test. But when you get to college, instead of them doing their homework and studying, they're trying to find a party. They got all these sprats and everybody, instead of them working hard, instead of them trying to do their homework and do what the teacher said, do and learn the stuff like they're supposed to, they get a cheat sheet, or they get somebody who had the class before them, you don't hear me? And they get some, what you call is a study guide. That study guide, and they say, well, it's just a study guide. It have kind of what was could be on the test. But if you get the prime study guide, if you get the study guide that you might have to pay $200 for, you guaranteed an A+. Because that study guide is the study guide. You don't understand me. And so is it in the work ethic. Some people find jobs not because they're knowledgeable, not even because they know how to do the job. It's because they got a cheat sheet. They got somebody in there that know them or know of them. And the true person that's qualified, you don't hear me? He's not even hired. And you wonder why some of these mines are blown up. All these people get killed because the engineers don't know what they're doing. They didn't learn what they're supposed to learn in college. Example, they told them don't put those levels. Don't put that mercury. Don't put that mercury sensor on. You know you never do a job in a mine without those sensors on telling you if there's gas, is there mercury, is there this, is there that. You need that stuff to know, because if the level go high, guess what it's time for you to do? It's time for you to get the world out of there, because the bad boy blow up. Then you got people who become mathematicians and they don't even know anything about math. They got students in the class know more about math than they do. Again, they get the job because of somebody they know. Let me tell you something. if you're not doing what God tell you to do, unlike this life we live in on this planet Earth, when you make a mistake, the worst, you get maybe fired and you find another job. But we're talking about your life. We're talking about your life. Do you know there's people in this world that refuse to do what God told them to do, and it cost them not only their house, their spouse, and all that, but it cost them their life. Because they couldn't listen. They couldn't do what thus said that God wanted them to do. God wants us as Christians every day, not some day, every day to get up and pray. He wants us to give him the honor, the glory. What a privilege. What a privilege it is to give the Lord the honor and the glory. What a privilege, so sweet, so wonderful. What is an honor to give him the glory? Not you, not the world, not everybody, but give him the glory. If God is telling you to do something, do it. I don't know why my church is not like this and my church is not like that. It's because you're not doing what thus said the Lord. Lord told Moses to do something. Now, some people may argue that what Moses said, I can't. Well, he brought Aaron with him. He said, Moses and Aaron came unto Pharaoh and said unto him, thus said the Lord, thus said God. God told those people to turn from their wicked ways. And when they turned from their wicked ways and they repented, God blessed them. But when God tell you to turn from your wicked ways, and you don't turn from your wicked ways, your clock begin to tick. Your time is running out. Your clock begin to tick. Your time is running out. God will tell you that you need to live right. You need to be right and do right. And if you refuse him, your time is running out. Let's go to the fourth verse. God will tell you, I don't care what you say. Your time is running out. Else, if you refuse, you don't hear me? God is telling you to do this thing. He might be telling you to go to a person and witness to him. God is telling you to do a thing. That thing might be that just merely get on your knees and get closer to him. God is trying to tell you to do a thing. That thing might be that you need to pray more. You need to do more. The thing might be you might have to be more positive and stop being negative. God did not make you a critic. You leave the critic for the critics on the news, the journalism. They're criticizing the way a person catch the ball. They're criticizing the way a person make a touchdown. They're criticizing the way a person make the Super Bowl. Can you believe in this world today? It used to be that if somebody make it to the playoffs, and even if somebody made it to the second round of the playoffs, you are guaranteed a job. You are guaranteed to have a place on that team. You don't hear me? They have people not only made the playoffs, they have people that made the championship. And even so, they wasn't even on the team no more because it's something they didn't like about them. It's something they did wrong. It's no more. I don't care if you're the best. You got to be the best, and then you got to be an awful time or lack it up. No, 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 ma'am, no, sir. When you're living for God, God don't ask that all of you. All you need to do is receive him in your heart. Receive them in your mind and your soul. You don't have to be a billionaire to be saved. You don't have to be a millionaire to be saved. You could be the poor. You could be the poorest person in the world. Because poor people going to heaven too. There's more poor in heaven than there are going to be billionaires and trillionaires in heaven. I don't think we have any trillionaires, but we have some billionaires. And just because you're rich, you think you can say something. Just because you are a genius and you know all about the science, you know all about the hemisphere, the atmosphere, the gravity levels, you know all the math, you don't hear me? But I don't care what you don't know or what you know. If you don't do what God told you to do, if God have an assignment for you, and if you don't do what God told you to do, you could be the richest of the richest. You could sing like nobody business. You could be the best of the best. And it won't matter if you don't serve Jesus. It don't matter if you don't have the honor and glory unto God and not honor and glory unto people. And they said, else, if thou refuse to let my people go, behold, the morrow will I bring the locust unto the coast. He's going to bring terror. He's going to bring problems. He's going to bring things to you. And then if you still don't listen, the clock is ticking. The time is running out. Don't you remember? I don't understand how people remember how other people didn't listen. And they still don't listen. They got this stronghold on them. They act like they don't know nothing. But them ignorance is no excuse for not serving God. Everybody telling you how you have to live right, do right. And if you play like you don't understand or you can't listen, that's on you. It's not on them, because everybody have to seek their own soul salvation. You can't seek your salvation through somebody else. You got to have your own soul salvation. You got to have your relationship with God. Not Jimmy, Susie, or Sally. You have to have your personal relationship with God. You can't be a follower. You have to be a leader. You have to believe and trust in God. You have to believe and trust in His word. He said, behold, tomorrow I will bring the locusts unto coast. The fifth verse. The fifth verse said, and they shall cover the face of the earth, that one cannot be able to see the earth. And they shall eat the residue of that which is escaped, which remain unto you from the hail, and shall eat every tree which groweth for you out of the fields. We went through a very devastating, traumatic trauma as a human being, as life as we know it. There's something happened in 2020 that I have never seen in my life. I've never seen this. You know, the Bible talks about that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard of what? What is it? Of the glory and the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Eyes have never seen, nor ears heard. Come on now. With God. Jesus had for me. What God had for you? Eyes. Help me, sister. Have not seen.
Ears.
Nor ears have heard the blessings
that's come upon me.
The blessings come upon me. Eyes have not seen.
Ears haven't heard.
Of the blessings.
Of the blessings. God's about to pour on me.
Come on, sister, sing that song. Eyes
haven't heard.
Eyes haven't seen.
Ears
haven't heard.
The kind of blessings.
Come on now.
God's about to bless on me.
Jesus. The blessings on me.
Getting ready.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard of all the blessings that God has placed upon me. How many people in the world want to live Honestly, how many people in the world wants to live? All you have to do is submit to God. Let go and let God in your life. And he'll save you. There's people are running out of time. This is so serious. And I could never understand how if a person's married and either the man or the woman serving God and the man serving God and the woman serving God, how you could even conceive to allow the devil to come against you. The devil has already lost. Remember in your mind, the devil has lost. The Bible says we don't fight against flesh and blood. So that argument that you're having in your house and people are having all around the world, marriage, because devil is trying to destroy marriage. Let me tell you something. You arguing with a miss. What did God tell you? You're arguing with a miss. That man that you're arguing with that's a millionaire, all that money is yours. That woman you're arguing with is submitting and doing what you need to do to get done. That's a mess. Don't let the devil destroy your home. Don't let the devil destroy your love that God encamps upon you. Are you doing what God told you to do? Are you living right? Are you being right? Are you doing right? Only you can answer that question. The Bible said, judge and judge not. I'm not going to judge nobody. I'd rather tell you what you need to do than to argue with you and tell you what you're not doing. You don't hear me? God is good all the time, not some of the time. We need to repent today. We need to allow God in our life. We need to make about face on sin. We don't need to become evil. We need to become good. We need to be a blessing to one another. We need to encourage one another. Oh yeah, I could say something negative, but leave the critics to the critics. Leave those critics criticizing football players, criticizing basketball players and baseball players. This man got over 1,000 yards and they still say something wrong with him. This world is blind. Don't let people say you can't do this and you can't. And even when you do it, they still have something to say. You could become a lawyer, doctor, all that. They still got something to say. Do you know how hard it is? Hard is it become a doctor? The fact that you made it is a blessing in itself. You don't hear me? They just can't do it. Don't worry about them. Pray for them. They just can't do it. Don't worry about them. Pray for them. They can't do what God told you to do, and you did it, and they can't do it. And they get mad at you, and they won't say things about you. You see, I don't worry about people the way they talk to me and talk about me. I live my life for God. I gotta seek my own soul salvation. I gotta be in God. I can't be in people. That's what's wrong with the world today. Too many people are into people. Let's be into God. Let's find out what God wants for us. Jesus, repent. Be baptized in the name of Jesus. And you will be filled with the Holy Ghost. Remember, do what God told you to do. God told Moses to do a thing. Moses did that. He had Aaron with him, but he did that. I'm telling you, you're losing out on blessings because you are not doing what God told you to do. Start doing what God told you to do and not what you want to do. Not the way you want to live. You got to live for God. Jesus, accept him in your life today. Worship him. Believe in him. Trust in him. Trust in his word. And he'll free you from sin. He'll be there till the end. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Kind of blessing. The kind of blessings that's about to fall on me. Cause victory is here. Keep the feet out the door. God's gonna know me. Cause I'm gonna let it. Thank you.